The Biden administration on Wednesday reached out to oil and gas producers, seeking their help in bringing down high fuel prices. Relying on three unnamed sources, Reuters reports that the talks have also included discussions on other issues, like reducing methane emissions. White House reporters attempted to ask President Biden himself what he is planning to do about high gasoline prices Wednesday, but the president simply walked away from the podium. An unnamed White House official reportedly said, "We are closely monitoring the cost of oil and the cost of gas Americans are paying at the pump. And we are using every tool at our disposal to address anti-competitive practices in U.S. and global energy markets to ensure reliable and stable energy markets." Left unexplained is exactly what anti-competitive practices in the U.S. and global energy markets this unnamed White House official lie. Not that it really matters, because what the administration is engaged in now is blame shifting, on a problem Biden's own policies have helped amplify. After all, Biden's canceling the cross-border permit for the Keystone XL pipeline as one of his first acts in office was seen as a highly anti-competitive practice, by oil producers as well as Canada, which would like to compete in the world market by selling crude oil to the United States. Now instead of buying oil from our northern neighbors, U.S. refiners source a similar grade from Iraq and Brazil. Wasn't Biden's other day one action of placing a moratorium on the federal oil and gas leasing program an anti-competitive practice? That moratorium, remember, was supposed to last 30 days, ended up lasting 8 months, and was only reactivated as the result of multiple adverse decisions for the administration in the federal courts. Eliminating the ability of oil companies to compete to lease federal lands is pretty uncompetitive.